Well, hi there. I'm Matt Adams with Loop. You know, we have engineers and customers that are spread throughout the United States, so it becomes really important to be able to do development work apart from the machine. And one of the ways that we do that are with a lot of the simulation tools that are built inside Automation Studio. Now, Automation Studio simulation is not just for logic, it's also for things like motion control and safety. But what I'm going to focus on today is talking about the motion control simulation capabilities that are built in Automation Studio. And as a bit of a teaser, they're very thorough and complete, and I just didn't come up with that description myself. It's literally in the drop-down menu. So let's dive into Automation Studio and take a look. So what we're looking at is an Automation Studio project that consists of some standard hardware, a PLC, drive, and a motor. And what I'm going to do is convert this into a simulation with the press of this button here. It'll take my project, put everything into simulation mode, and it'll actually go online and run on my laptop. So now what we'll do once our simulation comes online is we'll issue a movement command with the move additive bit of this map axis basic function block. And during this movement, we'll actually see that the position and the velocity update here live on the screen. So this is a pretty standard simulation tool that's available in a number of platforms, but where it gets a little bit more interesting is there's also trace functionality. So inside the physical view here, I can right click on this drive and go down to the trace menu. And I already have a trace configured that's going to do a couple of things on this first axis. It's actually going to record the position and the speed. So I've got it configured so that it will trigger upon motion. So when I run this starts tracing as configured, it'll be waiting for us to make the movement. Once I do that and an additional move comes across, it'll say here that the trace has been loaded. We can remove the previous one. And now we've got our position and speed being displayed here on the screen. Now there's some neat functionality with this tracing tool that most people don't know about. You can actually go through and insert an additional chart and then give it a new name and some units, and there's the ability to actually manipulate other charts within a single one here. So what I'll do is I'll take this formula and I'll insert a differentiation of the speed, and now all of a sudden I have the acceleration. And we're scaled by a factor of 100 here, but we see that acceleration was 360,000 and over here it's 3600, so we then know that those match. Now the simulation that we just traced here is perfectly idealized, so you wouldn't be able to get any following error or measure something like the motor current or understand what the torque is. But if you change the simulation to complete, that opens up an entirely different set of tools that you can use to do exactly that. Now in order to use this functionality, I'm going to switch programs to a more thorough one that has some function blocks that'll let us simulate some mechanics. Now this program should look very familiar, it's quite similar to the one we had before, but there's some additional function blocks. And what we have here are two specific ones. There's one for load sim coupling and load sim mass. And so I've added those into this program here, and I can do that exact same motion trace, but we'll notice a pretty substantial difference this time. In order to show this to you, what I've done with this trace is I've configured it so that I can trace the actual position, the lag error, and the motor torque. And we'll see that those aren't going to be idealized at all. I'll go ahead and start this trace up, and we'll make the same additive move here inside this program. We see here that it still moved to 400, and we also have some modeled lag error here, which is dependent on the stiffness and the dynamics of the system that's configured, including some of the tuning parameters that I put in. Our bottom trace is the motor torque, and after the acceleration portion settles out, we see that there's a measured value of 1.68 newton meters. Now, I wanted to see if this model would actually match some of the other tools we use, so I fired up ServoSoft. That's a tool that we use for sizing here at Loop. And I made a system that had the exact mechanics with the same amount of inertia and same movement profile. And when I took a trace here, I see that the torque that's in green has the exact same torque measurement of 1.68 newton meters. So that gives us a lot of trust that the tools that we're using are modeled identically. Another part of the simulation that I wanted to show you is taking a network command trace. So we're not just tracing the parameters that we have here, we're also tracing every single command that's issued from the centralized controller down to the drive. So these are all time indexed, and we can see that there's been a couple of commands that have been issued. We see this NC action for a PLC open function block. There's our additive move that we made. And there's even a command for loading the motion trace here. When I open this up, it'll say that it's going to do an upload of the trace. And that's what we're looking at right here. So thanks for learning about motion simulation with Automation Studio. We'll talk again soon.